beautiful, almost operatic quality. She has the robustness of a classical soprano, but she's using a little bit of that stylized straight tone. Hello, lovely humans of the interwebs. My name is Taylor Gonzaga. I am the artistic director and founder of Opera Cecilia. I am also an opera singer and a voice instructor and a contemporary musician. So overall, I know stuff about music and I like to talk about music on this channel. So I hope you all enjoy my content. It's been a hot minute since I've posted a video. I've been dealing with some mental health struggles, as I've talked about in some other videos. A little bit of anxiety, a little bit of depression. A lovely cocktail of all of those things. But then I was just like thinking back on like things that used to give me a lot of joy when I was a kid. And one of the things that popped into my mind was this book right here. So this is a book that I had when I was in elementary school, and I absolutely loved it and used it and read it all the time. And then I lost my copy. I don't know what happened to it. And I was missing it when I was in college. And so I ended up going on like thriftbooks.com, I think it's called, or like a book thrifting site. And I ended up finding another copy of it and I ordered it for myself. So now it is once again in my possession. And the book is called The Realm of the Never Fairies, The Secret World of Pixie Hollow. It's a Disney book based off of the fairies from Neverland, from the Peter Pan movie. I just remember being so fascinated with the fairies and fascinated by this book when I was a kid. And this book gave me so much joy because of all of the like detailed illustrations, which we're gonna get into and I'm gonna show you some of them in this video, that I went back to it and I read through the whole entire thing the other day and it just brought me so much joy. The reason I'm showing you this book is because an artist that was on an old album that was produced by Disney called basically Songs From and Inspired by Disney Fairies is the artist that we will be talking about in this video today. Her name is Laureen Mckennit, and then we're actually going to listen to an excerpt from one of her original songs that I found on YouTube after doing a little bit more digging and research on her as an artist. She's a well-known composer and singer. In a recording career spanning more than two decades, her eclectic Celtic music has received critical acclaim worldwide and gold, platinum, and multi-platinum sales awards in 15 countries across four continents. To date, she has sold over 14 million albums with a catalog that includes 7 studio recordings, 3 seasonal recordings, a live in-concert DVD, and 2 DVD documentaries. She's won 2 Junos, Canada's Premier Music Award, and garnered 2 Grammy nominations and has performed for Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. Less well known is the fact that she's a highly successful businesswoman as well, who has created an independent record label with celebrated international success. But first, we're going to talk a little bit about the Never Fairies book that I have in my hand here that I'm super excited to share with you all, a total aspect of my childhood, and tell the story of Tinkerbell a little bit after we listen to her contribution to this album made by Disney. And this song is called To the Fairies They Draw Near. We're gonna listen to it real quickly. I might do a little bit of a reaction and analysis of it, but not a ton because it's relatively short, but this is just how magical her sound is overall. And we'll talk about that more with her original music too.
When the moon comes up to shine her face, the birds are fast asleep, and the lanterns hang from every post. Fairies leave the keep, they join their hands and sing their songs that my soul can hear. In the springtime when the youth is new, to the fairies they draw near, to the fairies they draw near.
So So your first impressions of her voice initially is this beautiful, almost operatic quality. She has the robustness of a classical soprano, but she's using a little bit of that stylized straight tone so that the song has a little bit more of a mystical folksy effect to it as well. So it's not like formal operatic singing by any stretch of the imagination, but it has that beautiful soprano lightness and buoyancy to it. So I'm so fascinated by her voice, and you can tell that she leans into her storytelling whenever she sings as well. And so that's what I find so beautiful about her as an artist. There isn't actually like a moving video to this song. This is just an excerpt of the audio from YouTube. So you're listening to the song with me, but you can't see anything. But what's so beautiful about her voice is this purity, the soprano quality to it. And there's a femininity to it, but it's a strong, beautiful, it leads into the strength of femininity, of feminine sound, and of traditionally feminine sound, that is. And what I absolutely love about it is also the instrumentation and how there's a little bit of like a chaos or like this symbolic flying in the string instruments that you're hearing, especially during this piece. But at the same time, you get this beautiful lyrical line on top of it. So it's like the gracefulness of the fairies combined with kind of the impish qualities or the chaotic qualities of the fairies that are demonstrated in Tinkerbell's character, because she's a little bit of an imp. She's a little bit of a difficult personality, but at the same time, extremely charming and well-meaning. So it's cool that all of those things can come together at once in this song and be reflected accurately in the music. It's only a 51 second song, but it packs a punch for just being 51 seconds. So I want us to listen to the last half a little bit and how it ends on kind of that deceptive cadence or half cadence or cliffhanger, and how it kind of gives us this this element of wanting more. Fairies, they draw near to the fairies, they draw. I love that beautiful pure high note that she does at the end combined with the swelling of the instrumentation. It's such a beautiful effect. Like, I could nerd on forever about how magical this music is, but I'll also tell you why it is so magical for me. Like, it's nostalgic as heck. But if you guys don't already know, as I'm thumbing through this, the Never Fairies from Neverland are kind of created by, they were created by the laughter of children. And one of the only ways that they can die is if children actually don't believe in them, if a child stops believing in fairies, and then the other children have to clap to show they believe so that the Never Fairy doesn't die, which is kind of sad. But they're born from the laughter of a child when the child makes its very first laugh, and then that laughter kind of spins into its own energy force, and the most unique types of laughter make it to Neverland and turn into the Never Fairies. And when they arrive in this thing called their arrival garment, where all of the Never Fairies greet them, and then they figure out what their talent is, which is kind of not just their calling in life, but also determines what fairies are going to be their closest friends and how they're going to contribute overall to life in Pixie Hollow, which is, for the most part, quite harmonious. and so it's very, very cute. It's very sweet. All the fairies gather around to greet the new fairy that has arrived and is born from laughter, and she or he or whatever the fairy ends up being ends up arriving and deciding what kind of group of fairies they join and what their special fairy talent might be. As you can tell by my makeup, which has hints of blue glitter in it, and just this random, I don't know, it made me happy. I'm not a makeup artist by any means, but I wanted to wear some fairy inspired makeup today. So this kind of is meant to signify the swirling of waves and blue glitter, because if I was a fairy, I would definitely be a water talent fairy, because water is one of the places, being in water has always been a source of stress relief and peace for me. So if you know what kind of fairy you'd be or what fairy talent you would have, feel free to sound it off off in the comments. I think it'd be kind of fun to hear what everybody might be. This is the home tree, and it's this beautiful detailed drawing of this tree that has all of these different little houses and like fairy things in it. The illustrator of this book really outdid themselves. This is an example of what fairy furniture for their fairy bedrooms looks like. And it says, the fairies' bedrooms are on the upper stories of the home tree. Every fairy and sparrow man, which is male fairy, has his or her own private quarters here. Every room is as unique as the fairy who lives there. When a new fairy arrives in Pixie Hollow, the decoration talent fairies outfit her room in a way that best suits the fairy's talent and personality. A tree bark grating fairy's room might have a birch bark canopy on the bed, while a water fairy's room would get woven seaweed curtains and sea green walls. And then you get to the water talent fairies, and of course I have to show you that picture because it is so special to me, because that's totally the fairy I would be. And they can like twist and manipulate water, and they can help with water related activities around Pixie Hollow. So anyway, I don't want to spend too much time in the video on this book, but I just had to show you some of it because it just brings me so much joy. Now that we have moved into the section of the video that's more centered on Laureen Mckennit, I would actually like to go to one of her original songs now. This is a song titled 100 Wishes, and in my opinion, and it's like one of the most beautiful things I've ever heard in my life. So I guess you all will have to hear for yourselves. So this is her performing it live with a beautiful, beautiful band. So immediately you get this like beautiful down-home folksy sound in the instrumentation. I just love the way that the guitar works with the melody so beautifully. The accompaniment just kind of brings that that wholesome feeling to the music that I really, really love and take inspiration from for my own original music, which I will be actually premiering more of that to the channel soon, so stay tuned. But anyway, her voice is just as mystifying in a very, very different way than in the fairy track. At this point, she's singing to something that is obviously more personal to her. And she's telling such a vivid story with the lyrics. She's talking about, we would be in France again. We would be under the olive tree. We would be on an abandoned beach. Like she evokes these like really, really, really vivid storytelling devices, vivid descriptions of environments. And on top of that, her voice has this lyrical quality to it that sounds soprano-like and full at certain moments, but then pulls back into kind of a whisper tone at others. And I can't help but think that that's expressive. That's a way to an intentional way to shape the phrasings in this point. Not a vocal defect in any by any stretch of the imagination, because she proved on the other track that she can sing fully more consistently. But here, that push and pull of the dynamic going from piano to forte so quickly, loud to soft, is the fact that she is reminiscing maybe on past memories with this person and nostalgia and maybe even a little bit of regret, and talking about how she, maybe if she had 100 wishes, she would find a way to be with them again.
Spain again, dance beneath the olive trees, mingling bodies.
love the poetic quality of this music.
I would reach them to furthest distance. I could be right there now with you.
Listen to all the locations she's talking about. She takes us on a journey. So this instrumental has a little tiny bit of like a Spanish guitar feel to it, which makes sense because she's talking about Spain, but just absolutely beautiful musical styles that are being reflected here. I love it.
Do you remember the summer when we took to the coast of Clare, heard the ocean?
See, there's Ireland. She's talking about new locations. I love it. What I absolutely love about this is the fact that it's a repetitive melody. Like, she's doing relatively simple things with the structure of this song, but because of those subtle changes in the lyrics, it becomes all the more exciting and interesting to the listener, and they're like, oh, where she's gonna travel to next. Oh my gosh, the nostalgia of travel, of being young, of being with somebody you love and doing those things and making all of those memories. And kind of this entire song just evokes this beautiful feeling of nostalgia that is bittersweet, but there's a joy when listening to music like this of leaning into those bittersweet emotions instead of resisting them. And I think that's a big thing that music can help us do, is lean into the emotions that may be harder to feel. Bittersweetness and nostalgia has always been hard for me, at least personally, and that's some of the stuff that I've been dealing with mentally lately as well. So this music is kind of a soothing balm to me, and hopefully it kind of is to you as you're helping me listen to it. Absolutely beautiful song. It has such a pure heart to it, you know what I mean? This was just such a joyous video to make, not only because I got to go back to a nostalgic part of my childhood, but also because I got to discover a new artist through that. Sorry, our camera ran out of juice, and so I had to film the last little tiny bit of this video on my phone. But I was just wanted to say that this video was such a privilege for me to be able to make, and it's in re-examining aspects of our past that I truly believe we can like discover new things about ourselves for the future. So what a beautiful metaphor that I was able to discover this new artist through re-examining an aspect of my childhood and music that I listened to when I was a kid and a book I read when I was a kid. So just this video made me so happy. So I hope you all enjoyed it. Funny, silly makeup and all. And I will see you all around here again soon. Thank you so, so much for tuning into the OC YouTube channel and for all of you who have supported the channel so far. I promise you that more regular content will be coming your way, and some artists that we have already done, and then some artists that are going to be new to the channel. So I hope you continue to tune in, and I will see you all next time. Bye.